All right, we good? All right, thank you guys all for joining today. Before I get going, just want to acknowledge our front office team, Wes Wilcox, who's back there, Phil Jabor, Paul Johnson, on and on. I can name them all. All put in a ton of work, not just this past week, but all year. And you know, really thankful to them for all they do. You know, our framework heading into the deadline, I think really two things. One has been our mantra, I think, since we got here, which is to be disciplined yet aggressive when the time comes. But this year with where we're at, we also want to be very protective of the core group of guys that we've had this year that have gotten us to this point. Our starting lineup is one of the best, if not the best, in the NBA. And our bench units mixed in there have been fantastic as well. And our guys have shown they can compete with any team in the league. So we've seen, I think, our team improve throughout the year. And credit to Mike and his entire coaching staff for what they've done here in their first year. Their ability to get the most out of guys and get them playing hard night in and night out has been huge. And for all these reasons, you know, we want to continue to let this group grow and gel together and continue on the improvement path that they've been set on. We're also excited to welcome Kessler Edwards to Sacramento, a player we've been tracking back all the way to his college days, young, athletic, big wing, extremely versatile. We're certainly looking forward to getting him into our system and seeing what he can do. But at the end of the day, we as always did our due diligence and vetted the market. Ultimately, just made the one move. But you know, we want to make sure that we're letting this group and the continuity that they've shown continue to shine through for the rest of the year. So we know the job, as always, never done. We're confident in the team we built, and with that, I'll take questions.
What's up, sir? When you went into Thursday, did you have it in your mind that you guys were probably going to leave things as is, or did you feel like some more things could have potentially fallen through for you?
The whole week is intense, and so no, we certainly went in, you know, with our normal mindset, and had lots of conversations the entire week, all the way up till the final buzzer. And you know, it just this year we ended up doing less than maybe we've done in the past. But you know, like I said, one of the things we wanted to do was be protective of that group, and so you know, ultimately we explored a bunch of things, but none met that threshold.
I know being reactionary is never ideal, but seeing all the moves that were happening in the West, did that factor into your calculus at all?
I think I would say high level, no. You know, our group do a great job of preparing heading into the deadline, just like we do during the draft, so that we know what our value is. Obviously, as things change with our competitors, that can change that calculus, but we also don't want to be reactionary just to be reactionary. We'll never do that. The West is always tough. I've been in the West now for 16 seasons, and this is no different. We think we're in a really good spot, but we know we got 28 games left, and we're going to have to go and fight it out with some really good teams. But we're also confident in the group that has done that already for 54 games. So, you know, we're all confident, and most importantly, the players are confident.
Yeah, Monty, defensively, you guys have not been great all season. You're still in the bottom, like six in the league. Is that something that you just felt like you couldn't address at the deadline without messing with the core of the team?
I think defensively, look, we know we need to be better. I would say we need to be better offensively, too, and I think we can on both sides. We certainly struggled at the start of the year. I think we've been better, you know, kind of in this middle part of the season. But we know we're going to need to be even better, especially with what our schedule looks like going forward. But we think the guys here have already shown the ability to do it. We need to be a little more consistent. But Mike and his staff have done a great job. And I think we're 19th or 20th since December 1st. So better, but certainly not good enough. But I think there's been some signs of improvement. We want to see that continue while our offense continues to be where it's at in the top two to three of the league.
Monte, you talked about wanting to let this group continue to gel. How much does it come into play, and how much do you worry about not wanting to impact negatively a locker room or team chemistry or team camaraderie, and not wanting to break up something like that when making any kind of move?
Yeah, I think it's part of the calculus, and you know, we've turned over half our roster in the last year, so there's been a lot of change. We got a new coaching staff, and we said, I think at the beginning of the year, we don't know exactly what it's going to be, and we want to sit and evaluate and see what's going to happen. And obviously, there's been some ups and downs. We started 0-4. We really busted out after that. We've fought through some tougher times, but I think consistently, this team has shown that they will answer the challenge, continue to improve. So that doesn't mean that we didn't explore other things, because there could be those things, but we have to balance doing a move against the continuity, and just ultimately, you know, none of those came past that point.
Monty, how do you weigh the differences between evaluating your team in November, December, January versus post All-Star break and potentially a playoff run? Like, are you still in that evaluation mode of like, I want to see how this group does in this situation?
Yeah, I would say we're always evaluating, but less of an evaluation period. We're much more confident for sure now that we're, you know, at this point in the season. But there's always going to be new challenges. Our job's never done. It's definitely a 12-month a year kind of thing these days. Now our job is to go and figure out how to get this group, you know, to continue to do what they've done and come out on top and meet our goal of making the playoffs here by the end of the season.
Hey, Monty, you kind of addressed it, but entering the season, there were a lot of new changes and nobody really knew what this team was going to be. I'm just curious, was there a point in the season or maybe a specific game where you realized that this team was special?
That's a good question. I would probably point to the Utah game at home. If I'm going to get the sequence right, we're down one. De'Aaron missed a couple shots. We got a couple offensive rebounds, and I believe all five guys touched it. It was completely unselfish, scrappy. We had, by the way, I'll get back to this, but our second All-Star missed a couple shots, but then fought for the rebound. Harrison got it, kicked it to Keegan, who immediately swung it to Kevin, who knocked down about a 30-footer. And the place went crazy. But I think that just showed our guys aren't going to quit, but they're also going to be unselfish. They're going to get in the fight, and you know, they're going to be confident that when the ball hits their hand, they're going to knock down the shot we need them to. So if I had to point to one, I'd point to that. That was special. You know, there's been a lot of moments along the way.
Yeah, Monty, throughout this decision-making process, what was on your mind is what would make the end of this season a successful year?
We know what our long-term, you know, goals are. Certainly in the short term, we want to make the playoffs. Longer term, we want to become a contending team in the West. But our focus is what can we do tonight, tomorrow, and forward. And that's what I think has gotten us to that point. And Mike has done a fantastic job of doing that. If he's not the coach of the year at this point, I think something's wrong. But to have our team where they are now, I believe we have something like the most blowout wins and the fewest blowout losses. And I think that shows our guys get down, they fight back. And some nights we don't have it, but we're there trying to figure out a way. There was maybe a Memphis game earlier this year where we just couldn't make a shot, but our defense held us in it. We almost pulled it out in the end. There's been other times where it's all clicking and, you know, teams have a hard time sticking with us on both ends. So, you know, testament to Mike and what they've done. But I think if we continue that process, we're gonna get to where we need to get to, not just this year, but going forward.
Do you anticipate looking at the buyout market at all to add depth, or do you think you're pretty much done with the roster?
Like I said, 12-month a year job. We'll continue to look at opportunities that can help our team, but at the same time, not just our starting lineup, our depth has been great. We've had 10, 11, 12, 13 guys contribute You know, shout out to our Stockton team, who is first in the West right now. We've had Keon Ellis and Mias Keita and others down there developing. So, you know, we're confident our roster top to bottom. But, of course, if there's opportunities to continue to help that present, we'll look at those.
Yeah, Monty, getting Domas into the All-Star game had to be a huge thing for you, specifically because of the way that the Tyrese Haliburton trade was looked at. But how much does having Fox also there sort of validate everything that happened in that situation where you not only got one All-Star, but you got one that helped another guy get to the All-Star game as well?
Yeah, certainly not about me. That's about Domas and what he's done for this team. And he's just been fantastic from day one. And we run a ton of stuff through him on both ends. We rely on him heavily. It's a pleasure to watch him out there. And then De'Aaron, who's, you know, been, I guess, the new award, whatever it is, the Jerry West Award. I mean, De'Aaron's been amazing down the stretch in the clutch. I'm just so happy for De'Aaron. I had all my remarks about how, you know, I believe we have two All-Stars, even though it hasn't been recognized yet. I'm so happy it's been recognized. And, you know, those two guys, they're the engines that make us go. And, you know, it's the pieces around them. Harrison Barnes, who's, you know, certainly, I guess, our quote-unquote veteran leader. He's won a championship. Kevin, Keegan coming in as a rookie, on and on. Davion, Malik, Trey, Chemezi, Rashawn, you know, Terrence Davis. We go on. These guys, I think, all feed off those two guys and compliment them very well. And, you know, I'm happy for the recognition that they've gotten.
Look at all these accomplishments that you have along the way. You know, it's like the first time since so many years you get different franchise leaders. You got two All-Stars and so forth. Does this at all exceed maybe some of the expectations or thoughts that you might have had about this team before the season started? Has anything kind of surprised you or exceeded maybe some of the things that you thought this team could be?
I think, there's always some range of outcomes that can happen at the start of the season. You know, I think – our group felt really good about what we'd put out there and the opportunities that that the team had to grow. We got a coach in Mike who, you know, we felt could be the perfect coach and has proven that for this group. We had what we thought could be two All-Stars, which has proven out. We certainly wanted to add a lot of shooting around those guys and guys who can play hard and you know, be two-way guys. So I think a lot of the things that we thought could happen, and maybe some folks were more or less confident in those things happening, a lot of those have borne out, and we've seen that. But we're only two-thirds of the way through the season. I don't think they hand out playoff berths at this point. So we got, you know, one-third of the season to go, and you know, we're going to have to continue to answer those challenges like we've done.
They might not hand out playoff berths at this point in the season, but owners hand out contract extensions. How happy were you to get that? And now how big is it for you to be on the same timeline as Mike Brown as well?
Yeah, I'm first of all, obviously, thank Vivek and, you know, his support and everything along the way. And this is just, you know, I'm very happy the next step in our you know, in our relationship. My wife and kids were, you know, love Sacramento, so happy that we can you know, continue to grow our family here. But also, it, you know, mostly a testament to all the people that you know, help along the way. First and foremost, you know, Wes Wilcox, who's here. He's run his own team. He should be running one very soon, if not. Should already have been there. But Phil Jabor, who, you know, runs our entire personnel, he's going to be next in line. Paul Johnson already running our G League team into first place. You know, I think there's going to be multiple folks in the very near term that are you know, I'm going to have to be negotiating with the future trade deadlines, and they'll know all my tricks and I'll know all theirs. But that group and the rest of our front office, you know, is the reason for all that. And yeah, we're happy about, you know, what we got going, what we're going to try to finish this year, and now, you know, continue to go on in future years.
Monty, back to the trade deadline, can you share any insight on the current market value of second round picks? I know you have a collection of them. We saw multiple deals with five second round picks being moved for players. Just what is any insight that you can share on what that value is of a second rounder today?
Second rounders can be used in many different ways. We've drafted second rounders. We've traded them in different moves. We have sent a second rounder last year for a rights owned player. I think they're a currency. This year, there were a lot of teams trying to improve. There's a ton of parity across the league. And, that's a market, right? When there's more buyers and sellers, maybe that inflates some of those prices. But all those things are part of the portfolio, whether we, use them in pick and trade, in other ways. We're always balancing those things. But, just part of our portfolio that we try to do to get this team to where we need to.
Monty, this is obviously a fan base that hasn't seen the playoffs in 16 years. When you're operating at the trade deadline, how do you balance the idea of maybe pushing all your chips in to maybe make a move that's more win now, so to speak, versus, like you said, wanting to contend for the long run and years to come?
Yeah, we've said it from day one, but making the playoffs is very important and is our stated short-term goal. At the same time, we're also making sure that we're going to be here for a long time, and we're going to be in the playoffs. We're going to be competing. We're going to be growing. We looked at moves that may help us in the short term and help solidify that. At the same time, what this group's done, we have guys that have been in and out of the rotation that we think. Can help us. So I think we have a lot of depth already, and guys that have proven they can help us. We're happy about that group. And like we said, the continuity of the group is something that we haven't had as much of. We've had a lot of turnover lately, and now that we've had the success there, we think that can be a big part of our stretch run as well.
Yeah, Monty, heading into your second contract in not too long, how do you feel like you've grown as an individual and a general manager since when you first took this job?
I'm way less nervous at press conferences. Which I don't know. I hope that's a good thing. Although the first press conference, there was no folks there with COVID, so maybe that helped. But, I think we've had a lot of change in my time here, roster, coaching staff, even, front office performance staff, but we do feel like we're in a really good place. I try to surround myself with really good people and, listen to them. And, I think that's gotten us to where we are. I'm going to continue to do that. And, like I said, I hope the next step for us is, the sign of a really good organization is when your folks continue to get bigger and better jobs elsewhere. And then the next challenge for us is going to be how to replace those folks and keep this thing going. But, that's going to be a good problem to have. I'm just going to continue to find people that help me and, make me look better. So.
Monty, when you look at the group that you have now versus the years in the past, what sticks out to you the most on the reason you guys are having this recent success?
I don't think it's any one thing. It's sometimes it's hard to diagnose, how all those things are, but really I think it's the combination of, like I said, Mike, who should be coach of the year, the culture he's helping build, the culture he's really built and continues to, new players joining old players. So we've had De'Aaron and Harrison and Rashawn here, since I started, by adding Domas and Kevin and on down the line, those guys, how they've complemented each other. And just those guys building off of each other's success and building that confidence that they can do it. And I think every game we play, every win we have, continues to build that. The belief in that group is growing. And, I think it's not just one thing. It's the combination of all of them. And again, that's a big reason that we're happy with where the group is, and we're going to let them continue to grow here.
Any other questions?
Hello. If I can sneak in really quick, Harrison Barnes, such an important part of this team going into an off season where the future is undecided.
How do you weigh the decision of trying to maximize value at the trade deadline versus believing that you'll tackle that or cross that bridge when you come to it?
Yeah, just say Harrison is obviously a huge part of what we're doing. Harrison can play multiple positions, multiple, guard different guys. Coach puts him on a lot. He's a huge part of our team. And, not just on the court, but off the court, you know, with his championship pedigree, the ultimate professional. We all know the value Harrison has to us, and we're happy he's here.
All right, thank you, guys.
Okay. Thanks, guys.